Take a deep breath in, and on the out breath, close your eyes. With your eyes closed, just notice that you can give more of your attention to the sound of my voice. And as you breathe in and breathe out, just get a sense that you're breathing in a resourceful feeling of relaxation. And as you exhale, any feelings of tension, stress, and worry is leaving your body in your outward breath. Simply by breathing in enables you to feel deeper and deeper relaxed. Use the power of your imagination to imagine a bright, vibrant color that represents resourceful relaxation. Imagine that color going in, up through the nose, filling your lungs, giving you a sense of resourcefulness. Become aware of any feelings of anxiety or tension in your body. Imagine that melting away. And then as you exhale, imagine that dissipated, melted tension and anxiety leaving your body in your outward breath, perhaps with a darker color. Really focus on the vibrant, colorful nature of that energy going in, and observe the darker shades leaving your body, giving you evidence that you're becoming more resourceful and more relaxed. As you breathe in and breathe out, just get a sense that your arms are getting limper and loose. Tension in your neck is leaving. You're finding it easier to breathe deeper and exhale for longer. That's right. And as your body relaxes, I want you to get a sense that you are unlocking the part of you that is the glass half full side of you. You know very well there's a side of you that is very good at spotting where things can go wrong. You know there's a part of you that can see problems on the horizon that other people can't see. For many parts of your life, being able to preempt problems before they come up has served you very well. And I want you to thank that part for doing an amazing job. But like any tool, it's only useful for the particular job it has to do. A hammer is a wonderful tool, but you wouldn't use it to cut wood. A saw is a wonderful tool, but you wouldn't use it to drill holes. I want you to get a sense that these different parts of your personality are all wonderful in the right context. And for now, that part that likes to look out for the worst case scenario, this is not the right role for them. I want you to find that part of you that has a knack of evaluating things in a positive way, even if things look doom and gloomy. When that part is ready to come forward and is able to listen to my voice, let me know by nodding your head. That's right. I want you to notice that everything has two sides. I want you to think of a long car journey, for example. Some people would think of that long car journey and think, I just don't want to do it. Whereas other people would look at the same car journey and in that positive intonation inside their own mind would say, I really want to do that. I get to do that. Simply by being able to drive, there are many people that have a driving license, can drive, but don't get to drive. So thinking about that car journey, that positive part might be thinking, I want to do this, but more importantly, I get to do this, because so many people don't. And if that part is able to perceive a car journey, no matter how long it is something that is desirable to do, something you want to do, something you get to do, just let me know by nodding your head. And as you evaluate a car journey in that way, notice what emotion comes up. You've had car journeys in the past taking you to wonderful places, and you thought not of the journey but of the destination. The journey is just a stepping stone to get you to somewhere else. And perhaps back then you thought of not the journey but the destination and all the wonderful things you could do when you got there. Maybe as a child you can recall a journey that took you somewhere exciting. I want you to tap into that feeling of excitement and bring it to the forefront now as you now think of a future journey. And you access that feeling of excitement just by evaluating that this is something you want to do, you get to do, and it's taking you towards something valuable and important to you. Some people would take a journey and feel that they're trapped in a small vehicle. And yet others would look at driving itself as a form of freedom. The reaction of most people passing their driving test and getting a driving license and getting their first car isn't, oh, I'm trapped, but that this is a ticket to freedom. Holding the car keys in their hand represents freedom. Having a driving license represents freedom. And that positive, optimistic part, I want you to tap into perhaps the first time that you felt that freedom when you were driving. Access that emotion and then think of a future journey that you need to make. And notice that when you think of it in this way, that to drive is to be free. Not only is there no anxiety, but there is a feeling of excitement and freedom. An echo of that first time that you felt it. There are some people when they're traveling, they worry, but what if I get stuck in traffic? Whereas most people just accept that occasionally getting stuck in traffic is just a minor inconvenience, a side effect of taking a journey. The overall attitude is, so what? If I get stuck in traffic, I'll just listen to a bit more music in the car. I'll just daydream a little bit while I'm waiting and then carry on. And if you feel it's possible to perceive that getting stuck in traffic is just such a minor inconvenience, just let me know by nodding your head. That's right. And perhaps there was a part of you that used to worry that if you're on a long car journey, then what if you need to go to the toilet, have a break, and then start to think that isn't that the reason that they have all those service stations on the motorways? It's just a biological need for humans to go to the toilet every now and then. So the thinking can be, if I need to wee, then it can be. No big deal. If I need to go to the toilet, I can. And notice that with that evaluation, you've evaluated the stakes are so low that there is just no consequences, no worries. I want you to imagine holding those thoughts in that tonality in your mind, and then imagine taking that car journey all the way from beginning to end, picking up the keys, getting into the car. To drive is to be free. I get to drive. Driving, if there's traffic, thinking, so what? And at any point, if you need to go to the toilet, just deciding that you'll take the next exit to the service station, going to the toilet, and then carry on with your journey. Imagine taking a longer journey than necessary, simply because you like to drive. Imagine getting to your destination, doing whatever you need to do there, and feeling relaxed and calm. And then imagine driving back, also with this inner dialogue of, to drive is to be free. that this is something that I get to do, I want to do. That I can handle this. That whatever happens, I can cope, I can deal with it. If your unconscious mind is happy to accept not just these suggestions, but the foundation of a belief that they're built on, which is your emotions are a reflection of your evaluations and that you are the one in control of your evaluations. Just let me know by nodding your head. Imagine returning back in the car, back to your home, climbing back inside your body, feeling completely in the present, but activating this part and deciding that in the same way that you have a driver and a passenger, that for any car journeys, this optimistic part will be the driver. And perhaps that bit, that part that is really good at spotting problems can be a passenger but no longer the driver. To provide warnings but not be in control. Sometimes it's useful to have a passenger next to the driver to point out possible dangers on the horizon, but it's the driver that gets to listen. And if you're happy with that new relationship, that new dynamic, not just for driving, but for anything that would lead you to going out of your comfort zone from this point forward, let me know by nodding your head. Now it's time to return to the present. Take a deep breath in through your nose and out through your nose. Just wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. As I count from 1 to 10 to awaken you, you will awaken feeling highly resourceful, optimistic, and looking to expand your comfort zone. Starting to count. 1, 2, 3, waking up. 4, 5, 6, more alert. 7, 8, open your eyes, open your eyes. 9, 10, wide awake, wide awake, wide awake.